Hello everyone, welcome back to 2 Minute Tips. Let's get started. If you've ever wanted to customize your survey by changing the background color or adding a logo in a progress bar, you've likely already visited the Look and Feel menu. Look and Feel allows survey makers to customize many aspects of their survey's appearance. Throughout these next few videos, we will look at the different options available to us in each section of the Look and Feel menu. Today, we will focus on the General tab and go over how to change button text, customize the progress bar, specify the number of questions on a page, and modify the header and footer of the survey. Let's begin by navigating to the Look and Feel menu by clicking on the paint roller icon on the left-hand side underneath the workflow icon. Once you're on the page, go ahead and click on the General tab. Here, we will see a live preview of the survey that gets updated anytime we make any changes. You can switch between the desktop and mobile view by clicking on these buttons up here. You can also restart the survey and choose to display a sample survey with this dropdown. The next and previous buttons can both be edited by clicking on the text box and directly typing in your desired text. You can also choose to display a library message by clicking this dropdown and selecting the library and message you would like to display. This is especially useful whenever you want this text translated. If we go to our library and click New Message, it will open up a rich text editor where we can type up our message. If we delete the button text and don't add anything after, it will default back to the arrow symbol. The next two dropdowns allow us to customize the position and the look of the progress bar. We can click through these options to view all of the variations. The following text field labeled questions per page lets us specify a set number of questions per page. For example, if we only want one question per page, we can set this field to 1, click apply, restart the survey, and we will see that only the first question is displayed. These last two text boxes have the same drop-down library options as the button text, and they can also use any fixed text we type in the box. These differ by having this edit option here that opens up a rich text editor that allows for fonts and images to be used. Once we're done making edits on this page, simply click apply and publish the survey for the edits to go live. If we made changes but don't want to save them, we can click revert and Look and Feel will return to its last saved version. And that's it. Thank you for learning how to use the general section in the Look and Feel tab with me today. Please remember to subscribe to the 2 Minute Tip category on the XM community so you never miss a video. And I hope to see you around the XM community.